All right, going live, going live. Is the preview working? The preview is working. Okay, good, good, good. All right, so everything should be set. I got my subtitles on, got the timer ready. All right, let's do this. It is now officially 9 o'clock p.m. Eastern time. Welcome back, guys, to Streamwatch. We are watching Soul on Disney Plus. Let's check it out. All right, about to press play. Disney Plus original. Interesting. Oh, they're playing the Disney theme horribly. Okay. Ah, that is causing a big headache. So I assume this is the class of students. Okay. Okay. Oh, let me raise the volume, actually. Oh, come on. Wait, how do you not know that she forgot her sex? Why are you laughing? She's the only one that could play. Thank you. All right, timer is good. All right. He just said I could die a happy man. Oh no, he just sealed his fate right there. God heard him and he's like, okay, you're gonna die today. Where's Spider-Man? Why Spider-Man can't save him? That sounds like Angela Bassett. You know what this kind of reminds me of? That segment in Fantasia 2000, I think that's what it was, where it's like a very unique art style mixed in with the jazz music. I really love that segment, so it kind of reminds me of that. Yeah, it shows him hitting all the notes over here. Oh, hey, Next G Nima. Lo, that's crazy, I just finished watching. Yeah, I just started. It's amazing. You know, I did not like any of the trailers, but I was hoping this would be good. But so far, I am captivated by what I'm seeing and hearing. Like, wow, so far. Oh no, he's gonna die right now! Because I saw this part in the trailer! He did say he would die a happy man! Ah, he's gonna die now. Damn it! It's honestly not what you expect narrative-wise. You'll love it. Ah, thank you. Okay, now he's, a ghost. Or a specter, or whatever they call it in this movie. A spirit? Yeah, when I first saw this part in the trailer, I was really not looking forward to it because I was like, a movie about jazz and, you know, keeping it like semi-realistic, I would have been fine with. But the spirit thing is the one that took me out of the trailers, but hopefully it wins me over. This is pretty. The minimalism of it. So when you die, you keep some articles of clothing so you could wear a hat and glasses? Wait, when I'm dead, I need glasses? Aw, man. This does remind me of Patrick Swayze's Ghost. Why aren't you running?
I don't know.
Oh, she spoke in Korean. Where are my pants? Panso, origaso. How come you didn't see all these people before? So is this similar to like the Chris Rock movie Down to Earth? Oh, now the title sequence comes up? Man, it's 12 minutes in. Man, the music is so good. Whoa, that is cool. Yeah, it's like a cord being strung. This is really cool. You know, so far this film got me already. It's weird because I saw Tenet a couple weeks ago. I was disappointed. I saw The Witches a couple days ago. It was Wonder Woman 1984 yesterday. And it was a bit disappointing even though I had fun with it. But it's not a great movie. I expected it to be great compared to the first one, but no. Now this one just got me already. Abdullah Farouk? Mmm. Nice seeing you. Quiet Coyote. Hell? Oh, they're adorable. You know what? It reminds me of Loco Roco. Yeah, Loco Roco. What? Man, the animation on her is actually stunning. It's something simplistic, but the way the animation is really cool. Like, it's inverted. Ah. Yeah, that's the thing. I'm not sure if this is allowed to be in the Academy Awards because it's technically part of streaming, not in theaters. But it deserves something for music, man. Oh, cat, it's not that easy. You know, just hold on to a baby. Hold on to a baby. Yes, thank you. They're all Jerry. I say no. Oh, I'm loving this. I'm really loving this. Oh my god, I'm loving this. You know, I really did like Onward, but I don't think I felt this genuine joy ever since maybe Inside Out. I really like Toy Story 4, but again, I feel like that's Toy Story 3 had that joy, that kid in me, feeling so fascinated by everything. Oh, man. Oh my god, this is gonna take a while. Oh. I love it because the sound actually went from the left to the right. That was good. Oh, her head is chopped off. I love it. Oh my god, I'm loving this. He never knew, huh? Is that now? But Joe, even if you get back to Earth, wouldn't you be in a different body? It's not guaranteed that you would go back to your own body. Ah. Ouch. I'm loving this. How far am I? Almost 30 minutes. Okay. Ah, man. Even president. Come on, let her become a pyromaniac. It should be fine. Oh my God, I'm loving it. Just a box? What the? Okay, now I'm getting like Little Big Planet vibes. Oh, I see Joe Ramp. I see that name. Oh no! Oh, you're the one who makes the Knicks lose. Oh my God. Oh. Oh, man. It's very hard to imagine silence if you're hearing music. So he's not dead yet. Oh no, are they stuck in the cat? Ah, they're stuck in the cat. Ha! Oh my God. I think there's going to be a huge problem where she doesn't want to leave the body. She's going to love living. Oh, man. It's a small... It's a small moment, but I love that when, Tina Fey was adjusting her glasses, looking through it, the light was shining off the glasses. That was good. I love it. Oh, it reminds me of Man of Steel. She's not used to hearing all this. Wait. So no one cares that a guy is in a hospital gown out in public? Well, I guess it's New York City. If we don't see it, we don't care. You're actually gonna steal pizza? You drop a gyro. Nope, you're enemies now. How'd you get the pizza again? Oh, you stole it again. Uh-oh. Again? Oh my God, you're creating monsters! Oh, is that, the voice sounds so familiar. Is that Ron from, no, not Ron. Rod from Get Out? I'm trying to remember the actor's name. Oh! Yeah, he looks better that way. Oh, he never, he never truly experienced life. That is so weird. Oh, the animation is so good for him. Oh no! Oh man, I love it. Cover the butt. Where'd you get that? No. Oh, you gotta be specific, man. I knew it. Ha 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 ha! Does she hear the cat meowing? Aww. 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 Man, this movie is so gorgeous. Yep, thought so. Oh no. Oh no. Oh no! Wait, isn't the cat dead? Like, the cat has no soul, right? I'm confused. So is he gonna meet up with Moonshine and then try to get 22 to go back to Earth? She kept the pizza crust in the pants pocket? Wow. My God, that bagel looks amazing. That's like the most prettiest eaten bagel I've ever seen. Also, the lollipop looks good too. Man, the renders. Seriously, it looks so realistic. Aww. Oh, he's gonna find his transcendent space and get to her. Okay. I see what's going on. Wait, he's no longer wearing the hat, so why would he have a hat on him? Oh, Moonwind. Sorry, did I call him Moonshine? Great, now she looks like a heartless. This segment is really good. Nope, screw that. I am not shedding it. Nope, damn tears. Let me guess, he's gonna live again. I'm pretty sure they're just gonna cut it. Yep, Jerry. See? I mean, I'm happy, but at the same time, I kind of wish that Pixar has some balls. Call Lisa. Soul. Well, you know, even though I wish Pixar had some balls and just have them go to the great beyond, but I am happy. This movie was so good. It's funny because I did not like the trailers for this. I honestly was dreading this movie. But I am kind of glad that I hated the trailers because that set my expectations so low. So this movie is just amazing to me. And also, it helps that I watched movies that ended up disappointing me. With Tenet, Wonder Woman 1984. Then I watched this. Wow. Original score by Trent Reznor. Oh my god, really? Trent Reznor worked on this. Nice. Oh my god. The animation's great. The renders look awesome. The voice acting is super good. I honestly thought a ghost wacky spirit voiced by Tina Fey was going to get on my nerves. But no, I liked her. I liked her a lot in this. And I do like Tina Fey, I do. It's just the idea of it sounds horrible to me. But man, everything worked out. Everything. And yes, like I said, the ending was a bit too safe, but I honestly, it's fine. I'm fine with it. Overall, I got an incredibly entertaining movie. And wow, it's so imaginative too, even though it does remind me a lot of Inside Out, but I loved Inside Out. I also love this one. I cannot wait to get this on Blu-ray, to be honest. And yeah, I know it's basically part of Disney Plus, so I don't have to get it on Blu-ray, but this is like a Blu-ray purchase for me, man. I have to wait like, what, 5 more months? Oh, man. I can't wait. Even though, yeah, it's part of Disney Plus, so technically I have it forever as long as I have Disney Plus, but yeah, wow. I gotta check up the... Oh, thanks for the cast. Jamie Foxx, Tina Fey, Graham Norton, really? Rachel House, Alice Braga, Richard Iotti. Oh, that was Richard Iotti. Angela Bassett, uh-huh. Wes Studi. Aw, look at the little guys. So I guess that's it, right? I don't think there's an extra scene, is there? Aw, at least they're showing cute animations with the little guys. Yeah, I'm skimming through. I don't think there is anything at the end. Okay, so... Wow, that's a long credits then, because I have 12 minutes and 50 seconds left. Wow. Okay. Other than the ending, even though I was fine with it, I honestly thought, I'm not sure if there's anything I would change in this. I mean, even I love the slapstick in this too. Everything with the cat. And yes, if you told me the idea of it, I think it would sound lame, but man, it was actually well executed. It's well done. It's funny. Man, this was good. And yes, I did like Onward earlier this year, but this is way better than Onward. And you know what? Both Onward and this one did make me cry. Onward, the brotherhood of in Onward made it work so well. And also, the end got to me, where Tom Holland's character sacrificed him meeting his father. And he gave it all to Chris Pratt. And wow, that got to me. This one, yeah, 22, about to live her life, got to me too. And also, when they show a couple of the scenes with Joe's dad, also got to me. Man, fantastic movie all around. Again, because this is on Disney Plus, I think that's the rule, right? You can't be nominated for an Academy Award, which is kind of bullshit when you think about it. Because it deserves to. It deserves to win Best Animated Feature. And to be honest, there's really not that many animated features this year. Unless My Hero Academia counts. That would be interesting. I love that movie too, but it's nowhere in league with this. And that's a whole different genre, to be honest. That's a superhero anime. I love it, though. I really love it. Oh, man. The music is so good. Yeah, it has to be nominated for the music, at least. So, yeah, 2020 changed a lot for film, for better and for worse. And a lot of the movies ended up streaming or direct on demand. I mean, I guess I'm trying to remember what the rules are. I know if you show it in theaters, I guess it counts. But since, again, this is only on Disney Plus, I don't think it's in theaters anywhere, right? Unless it's in theaters outside of America? But I don't think so. But yeah, after watching Wonder Woman yesterday for Christmas, and again, I don't hate Wonder Woman 1984. I was disappointed in it, but even though I did enjoy it, I had fun with it, but it's not as good as I hoped for it to be. This one was way better than I thought it was going to be, and I loved every single second of it. It's really good. I could just keep on talking, but I don't know what else to talk about. So, I'm going to end it here. Thanks for watching Streamwatch. Dang it, I can't believe I cried. I was holding back tears. I love this movie, man. I can't wait to show this to my family. All right, thanks for watching, everyone. Later.